So today, you, me, and Flangelica Foofy are going to be starting a resort. She looks very happy to be doing so. Originally, I wanted to turn this uncharted island that we found into a resort, but the lot is a little bit small. Instead, there's a lot here, and I want to purchase the property. Off we go in our little taxi. Why didn't we get our houseboat to move? I wanted the houseboat to come down here. Oh, well. What I'm thinking is we buy this resort and then we build it up. How's that going to go? Absolutely no idea. I could have done it the lazy way and just got a pre-made resort, but I really wanted to make like a scatty looking resort. I didn't want it to be nice looking. Oh my God, we give it a name. Oh my God, we're calling it Casa Flangelica. Absolutely lovely. Casa Flangelica, where are you? I've already lost you. Oh, here you are. So all we have right now is a front desk and a trash can. So we can go in resort management, improve resorts. What's blueprint mode? Oh, that's when it has like pre-made rooms. So I can just plop that down, preview blueprints. Oh, that's actually really cool. Love that gameplay mechanic, but we're kind of doing it like rags to riches in a weird way. So we can't be too fancy to start off with. I'm going into this totally blind. Like, I do not even know if what I'm doing is correct. Oh my God, the lot isn't even flat. I tell you now, building in The Sims 3 is bloody horrific. It's so difficult. Anyway, I'm going to try. We also obviously need to create a pool. By the way, in The Sims 3, we had curved pools. Sims 4 could bloody never. So we'll chuck a bit of that in there. My God, water slides. Although, unfortunately, like, we're running out of money a little bit fast. This is all I've come up with. God help me. I know it's cheating a bit, but, like, I am just kachinging us a little bit of money just to get set up because, like, we do need it. This isn't supposed to be rags to riches. Like, this is supposed to be just a Sims 3 let's play. It's not that deep. I know I'm a cheat. I know. You'll get over it. Although, it's starting to look a bit more like a hostel. Very scary looking hostel. Oh my God, look how big this light is. Lighting, honestly, lighting in The Sims 3 makes me want to scream. I hate it so much. I've noticed you can also get beach bungalows. Now, I've just realized potentially these bedrooms will not be functional. Instead, you have to do the beach bungalows. It also comes with a resort tower where people can stay. So maybe I did it a bit wrong. I literally haven't looked at any guides. Oopsie. I have just done it completely blindly. Although I do want a beach bar. Yes, I do. So don't tell me, because I already know this is the best looking resort you have ever seen in your life. I mean, there's a lot of things we've got to do. Okay, firstly, we've got to hire new employees for the food stand. I'm just hiring random people. We've got to toggle on room service, or we can change the color of the bungalow. That's very nice. We need to hire an employee for the beach bar. I think we need to hire a receptionist, or shall I operate the front desk? Oh, I think we can set rooms. So we can do resort management. I don't know. Maybe we could set VIP door lock, make this a VIP room. There we go. This room here is the VIP room. So I'll operate the front desk. Come on, Flangelica Foofy. Stop being lazy. Get to work. She's giving somebody the side eye and she's not even working. Is she an animation glitch? Right, for Christ's sake, Flangelica Foofy. I'm gonna have to save a bloody restart because you're in an animation glitch. For Christ's sake. At least I gave my PC 5 minutes to cool down, because like the fan goes absolutely mental when I put this game on. Guys, don't you miss like the old Sims loading screens where they were different for like each pack you owned? I really miss that. Anyway, it seems it's all working out now. Flangelica Foofy is having a whale of a time. Absolutely no idea what she's doing. She's totally clueless because she's uneducated and she's never been employed in her entire life. I mean, I could get Fanny Maylie Jones to help, but she's having fun riding a houseboat. What is Moist Miriam doing? Oh, she's taking a shit. Well, you enjoy your poo on your houseboat, Miriam. It looks like Flangelica Foofy is the only one holding this place together. I mean, do we have anyone here? Oh my God, we have a mermaid. Oh my God, the camera's growing mental. Sir, I can't fight. Oh my God, we've got a mermaid. Oh my God, and he's sexy as well. Oh my God, mermaid man, I want to have sex with you so badly, but I am busy managing my resort for my one guest, the sexy mermaid. Oh my God, we got to set food. Oh my God, I didn't realize. Oh my God, it's dinner time. Here we go, we set it as dinner food. Oh my God, this person's angry because we've neglected him. Oh, for Christ's sake. Is he leaving? Oh no, he's leaving the resort. This policeman. Hunky policeman, don't go. Don't go. I'm sorry. What's he doing? Oh no, he's just checking in. Absolutely lovely. So where does he go? Okay, he's gone into the room. Oh my God, he's gone into the VIP room. He's looking around like, oh my God, what is this shit? It's all right. He's having a fun. He's doing a little bit of diving in our pool with our mermaid. Wherever the mermaid's gone. At least we've got a beach bar. So that's always good. Looks like our mermaid mermaid is finally sitting down to eat something. Oh my god, he's choking. Don't die in the resort. That would be tragic. Oh my god, he's angry. Everybody's so angry. I'm so sorry to all my guests that you hate this space. I'm so sorry. I'm sorry. I don't know what to do. He just keeps like grabbing new food. Like, how much food do you want to eat, mate? How much do you want to eat? It's 1 a.m. What are you doing? What on earth are you doing? Is he grabbing? Oh my god, for Christ's sake. Why is he changing seat each time? For Christ's sake. Right, can we just like get rid of the food? I don't think we can get rid of the food right now. Can we? There we go. It's all gone. Sir, get to sleep. Oh my god, I completely forgot about the check-in desk. I think we need to hire somebody to do it because Flangelica Foofy is too lazy. Oh my god, Casa Flangelica is currently unprofitable by 167 simoleons. Oh no, that's not good. Apparently you can improve your star rating with lots of nice decor. So definitely not by using the motherlode cheats. We can now afford some nicer decor because I would like a nicer looking resort. I mean, I'm using motherlode because I'm being a bit lazy, but like if I was doing it properly, I think I'd really enjoy doing this. Like doing kind of like a rags to riches resort style thing. I think it's a fun idea. Apparently like if you just get some random expensive things, it should improve the rating, and I am being very random, just putting anything down. It is a little bit exploitive and cheaty, but I do not care. Anything goes in Casa Flangelica. Apparently landscaping helps too. In practice, that means I'm going to dump a load of random palm trees around. It is a little bit of an exploitive way to play, but you guys know me, like I'm not the kind of person that does these really long let's play video series. Like I just want to get it over within about 3 episodes and move on to something else. I do have a short attention span. I'm sorry, that's why I'm being a bit lazy. I mean, it looks, oh my god, I forgot we had Stonehenge in The Sims 3. Should we put Stonehenge on the lot? Can we? Oh, we can't fit it. That's a shame. Can we plop it here? Or is it location out of bounds? No, can't do it. Apparently, if you use a custom fountain too, it should also make it a lot nicer for your guests. And when I say nicer, I am putting in the minimum effort. I think maybe if we have some more of these island lodges too, we can maybe make some more money. Or we could always get like a humongous thingy here. I'm going to have to get rid of all these bloody decorations now because they're in the way. But I could do a resort tower. So we can fit like hundreds more guests. So our resort has had a glow, well, a glow down, not a glow up. We can upgrade it for 10,000 simoleons. Oh my god, let's do it. Oh, we added a new level to it. Great. So we can review the resort finances, expenses, revenue. Okay, so it looks like we got 71 out of 71 occupants. Revenue is greater than expenses. That's all good. I love how like literally everything has a maintenance cost as well. Like you can get really deep into the management of this. It's actually quite cool. You also need to hire a maintenance crew. Didn't realize. Okay, let's hire one person. Will that be enough for now? Resort reviews. Oh my god, they're all less than 1 star. I mean, to be fair, all of these came in like yesterday when I didn't deal with the resort properly. So maybe it'll be a lot better now. We're just gonna have to wait another day and see what will happen. We can set the price. Let's set it to moderate because we have made it look a lot nicer. Also, we can assign the uniform for our resort. Oh, we've got Spanish style. Let's do Spanish style. That sounds good. Has he changed much? Would you say this is Spanish? Not too sure. Anyway, seems like we have more guests. Oh my god, I keep forgetting guys to set the bloody food. All right, lunch food. Let's go. I genuinely can't help it. I'm sorry. I wish you could hire an NPC to do it for you, but I just keep forgetting. Anyway, guys, love that we have water slides in The Sims 3. Sims 4 could never. Oh, and we got a, what do you call these? Oh, a diving board. That's it. I think that's base game as well. Sims 4 could never. We do have food and drink stands, although the staff look rather bored because nobody's coming, but it's there if we want it. Although I feel like these rooms are not really like functional. Forgive me if I'm wrong. Oh my god. Oh my god, there's a cockroach on the under the bed. Are you guys seeing that? Oh my god, there's cockroaches everywhere. Oh, for Christ's sake, not the fucking cockroaches. That's not what this resort needs. I mean, it looks like the kind of place you'd see a cockroach. Oh my god, the sink. Oh no, everything's breaking down now. Oopsie. Oh my god, is that our staff member, Brendan Gossett, taking a break? How dare you take a break? You are supposed to be doing your job. I mean, look, even Flangelica Foofy's getting involved now. Even she's cleaning the place up. I think you need to get off that cow plant sofa. It's a good job for you. We don't have the extreme violence mod in The Sims 3 or there'd be hell breaking loose. I mean, seeing that we've got 71 guests, like there's nobody here. I guess it's supposed to be like fake guests. I don't know. At least we can still see some people. Is anything else broken or real? I think we're all right. The game is asking me to buy a resort buffet table for my resort. We literally already have one. I don't know what it wants from me. Unless we just do another one and set it as a different kind of food. Should we set this one as like sushi? That way we have a little bit of everything for everyone. Although, do we literally just have the same rolls on each plate? That's not very good. Oh my God, this flies. Oh, for Christ's sake. I can't deal with it anymore. Honestly, I can't deal with this resort. Flangelica Fufi, your resort is way too far gone, I'm afraid. Oh my God, look how dirty this sink is. We are working overtime and it's not very good. People don't seem to be using the outside very much either. They just go in the pool. Nobody's using anything. What if, okay, I have an idea. We could always try and build a second resort tower and we can upgrade this bungalow into another one here. And definitely not by using the motherlode cheat. We can upgrade like all of these places. So, oh my God, look at that. You can actually make it like taller. Oh, and it has spa services. Okay, let's do that. Oh, look, now you can get a facial massage, tattoo, body treatment, salon, other packages. That's really cool. We'll just upgrade all of the buildings. Definitely not by using motherlode. We'll change the color of the other one. There we go. We've got a pink and a blue one, a boys and girls one. So I feel like our resort's a little bit better. Although now we need to change lunch to dinner food because it's almost 8 p.m. For Christ's sake, I keep forgetting. Do you know what? I'm going to change this sushi already to breakfast because I know I'm going to forget breakfast when we're at it. I mean, according to our finances now, we're spending a lot more money. Each of these towers is costing 1,800 simoleons each time, but we can have up to 192 guests now. It's roughly half filled and our revenue is still technically higher than expenses, so we're still making money. We don't have any better reviews, although none have come in yet. I guess we have to wait until midnight. Oh my God, the game wants us to buy another resort buffet table. Why do you want so many buffet tables? Right, I'm going to get rid of some of these chairs here because let's be honest, they're not even being used. Maybe we could just have like multiple buffet tables for multiple different things. I feel like that's the best way to go about it. Okay, let me just like get this straight. Okay, food type, breakfast. Food type, lunch. This one, food type, dinner. Okay, and then we can set a couple of special ones. So we could always do desserts and then we could always do kids food. So that should be fine. Oh my God, is the sink broken again? For Christ's sake, look, the guest is cleaning it. This is so embarrassing. Why is the guest cleaning it? Oh my God, this guest here is vomiting in the toilet. Now the toilet's dirty. What the hell is going on in this resort? I mean, to be fair, it's like a pretty standard thing to happen in a resort, but it's a bit annoying for Flangelica Fufi at least. Anyway, at least this guest is helping me. Or is she, oh no, she's a staff member. I didn't realize. Well, thank you, Rosalind Landry. You are very helpful. Although she looks a little bit moody. She doesn't want to do a job. Why are you complaining? Am I not paying you enough? Is minimum wage not enough for you? Also, like the food is looking a bit like green and stinky. It's got like a stinky aura on it, but you can't clean it. So I don't know what to do. Unless I change the quality to high. Will that resolve it? Should we make it high for everything? That would always be good. Although I like how the food changes when it's high quality. Sims 3 was a haul for details. Anyway, I was going to say before, but I got distracted. I think if you want to have a custom room like this, do you have to set it as VIP? I think you do. I've just set these three on the right as VIP and the ones on the left as not. So we'll see if anyone stays in the left or right ones or not. Honestly, I'm not too sure. Anyway, we may as well get Flangelica Fufi to actually enjoy her own resort. Should we have a little chill in the hot tub? I think we should. If the game's a bit laggy, by the way, it's because this is Island Paradise. Like, it's born to be laggy. I love how her pink eyeshadow and lipstick is just really like glowing in the darkness. I do actually like how you have the option to like do the set bungalows that they've got here, or you can make like resort towers. I wish they had more tower designs, but I like that they've got it. I like that you can also make like normal rooms. I think it's honestly so cool. It makes me really wish we had this in The Sims 4, but I know even if they did do it, it'd be a laggy broken mess. But I think it's cool. I just wish we had guests staying here. I guess we probably won't because we've got these towers now in the way. And to be fair, if there's one thing The Sims 3 is bad at, it's filling lots with townies, whereas The Sims 4 is a lot better than that. That is the benefit of a closed world system. The open world system is a little bit lonely. Oh, look, we make 369 in profits. Oh my God, get in there. That is amazing. As if we're profiting from our little resort. We got a review in and it's gone up from 1.5 stars to 2. We started on 0, then got a half, then got 1.5, then got 2. Does it go up by like half each day then, assuming it all goes well? I'm assuming that's how it works. I want to see if you can purchase like another pre-made resort. I'm sure there was one somewhere. Is this a resort? It is. Let's purchase the property. Haven't looked at it yet. Could be shite. Well, it won't be as bad as my resort. Oh, look, Flangelica Fufi's got a car called Sloppy Jalopy. That sounds like a slang term for like a blowjob or something. Do you want a sloppy jalopy? Right, that is going to get me demonetized because I said the word blowjob in the video. Oops, that was my bad. Anyway, in the sloppy jalopy we go, because we are going to buy Casa Flangelica 2.0. I love how you can buy properties in The Sims 3. It's the base game thing. I wish you could do it in The Sims 4. The Sims 4 honestly has nothing and it makes me so mad. Anyway, we can give it a name. The other one's Casa Flangelica. What should we call this one? Complejo Flangelica. I love how like ugly this resort looks up here compared to the beautiful world. I mean, let's have a look at our new resort. See, that's a lot nicer. That is genuinely a lot nicer. Oh, look, you can have custom different kinds of cabins. I didn't know you could do that. That looks really beautiful, doesn't it? Oh, look, and it's got like the VIP rooms, I believe. Although I think the Sims team forgot to put lights in because it's very dark anyway. Yeah, that's, this is a lot nicer than my resort, I'm telling you now. Oh, look, and it's got downstairs gym. Absolutely perfect. Should we look at the reviews? See, this is almost 5 stars already. So we are cheating by taking it, but I don't care. Although it's got not that much revenue, but the expenses are very high. So we've got to deal with that. I mean, we've only got 11 out of 44 occupants. I think I'm going to just wait a minute and just see if we can get more occupants over time. I just feel like by owning it, maybe the game will be a little bit more generous. Also, by the way, I love that you can actually live in your own resort for free. So you can literally turn in for the night in one of these cabins, which is cool. You can also get like free beauty treatments if you own one. So we can get a volcanic clay bar. Enjoy Flangelica Fufi for doing absolutely nothing other than exploiting the motherlode cheat. I mean, she deserves it. She does. She worked 5 minutes a day and she is so exhausted. She bloody needs it. So how are you feeling, Flangelica Fufi? She doesn't look too impressed. Oh, now her eyes are wide. I wonder if she's on meth. I can't think of any other reason. Oh, what's this person doing? Oh my God, he's just lounging around on there reading a book, giving us a view of his very peachy shorts. I haven't done this, but apparently though, if you build your resort over the beach, apparently like it can make a lot more money. I mean, at least there's a spa right next to our resort. God, I love that you can just become a partner with a place, get shares in like a building, like The Sims 3 was very good for that. Anyways, oh my God, what is this? What is this in this world? Is it a little like monument? I think we're looking at it from the wrong angle. Not sure what that is. That is pretty creepy, but also pretty cool. So having a check-in on Casa Flangelica, how are you doing? We're still making money, so it's better than our other resort. Although Complejo Flangelica still only has 11 occupants, I think it's going to be an issue. Maybe we can build an area with like more rooms. Maybe if we get rid of this weird seating area, let me just change it today. We could always move the fire pit somewhere else. We'll still keep it the same-ish design. I'll actually try this time and make it look a little bit nicer than we did before. I don't know how big of a place we can build though. Can we, oh, for Christ's sake, can't be placed on a slope. Honestly, building in The Sims 3 makes me rage. You have to flatten every single lot and it's so annoying. Will that fix a blimmin' issue? Right, it has, although that's a little bit too big. You could just plop a tiny one here. Though I think it's a bit weird. It's right over there. Should we, oh my God, why is there a person on a tower here? This man with a peachy bum. First, he was up here. Now, why is this tower here? What are you doing there, mate? I'm sorry, but I need to build over you. I'm sorry, but it needs to be done. It says, oh my God, can't intersect objects. This is so annoying. Right, sir, please go away. Please. You're ruining everything. If I call him over to me and then he'll fuck off. There we go. Thank you. So just extending this out, like it's just big enough. Though I'm not sure if we can change the design this way. I know we can change the color scheme. It's just a little bit ugly. Do you know what I mean? Okay, there's no, if I want it a Spanish one, it has to be the big one. That is actually a little bit annoying because, you know, what if you want to have a smaller one that's also a Spanish design? Not too keen on that. There need to be more like little resort huts in this game. Not that like EA is ever going to update it. That would never ever happen because it's The Sims 3. Although it's an excuse to build like an area behind this little beach bar if we can go for the bigger Spanish one. Okay, yeah, that fits a lot better. We'll just chuck some little seats over here. Maybe a little table. Pretend that we at least try to make it look a little bit nicer than it currently does. Well, I can't say it's the most inspired, but I did try a little bit. Although I want to upgrade it and make it a lot bigger. I love how you can upgrade it like that. I think it's pretty cool. Like, I know it's not possible in The Sims 4, really, for there ever to be hotels. But what I think they could realistically do is create, like, a motel. So it's, like, not as big as a resort. And that it's just kind of, like, a cheap place, like, you stay in because you have to. But, you know, maybe they don't necessarily have cooking facilities, but some of them do. Like, I just feel like maybe if you do a hostel system where you design each room, maybe there's just just a maximum of 5 rooms on the lot to avoid lag. And you have like a communal kitchen where you can either hire a chef or your personal sim could work there, and like a communal bathroom or like a communal dining and living space. I think that would work completely fine in The Sims 4. I mean, nothing works completely fine in The Sims 4, but it would be the next best thing. Anyways, now we are officially at full occupancy. So our revenue is now higher than our expenses. So that is absolutely perfect. Raking in tons of money here. Well, 2 grand a day. Well, to be fair, I feel like 2 grand a day is a lot of money. Although we did cheat our way up here. I think if I started like properly, like if we did it a lot more like realistically, we could have started on like a little, I say realistic, we could have started on a little island like this and made a cute little resort and then built it up as we went along. We change a color scheme to this one too. There's a couple of different ones that we can choose from. Oh yeah, I really like that one. Okay, let me change them both to this one. See, it's all coming together nicely. Not that I built any of this lot at all. I didn't do anything. I added a foundation and a new little, what do you call these again? Like villas. I added some villas. By the way, guys, the lag is so much improved. If you want to improve the lag in the Sims 3 Island Paradise, get rid of any kind of houseboat that's tied to these ports. Get rid of all of them and it works so much better. It is insane. It's a little bit annoying, but to be fair, I feel like having like a weird little houseboat like this, like it's a cool gimmick that you want to do for yourself, but you don't need to see like other random townies with them. And like just having one by myself, I think is completely fine and it doesn't cause any lag. And oh my God, look at this. Casa Flangelica made almost 5K. That is pretty cool. We want to own a 5-star resort now as our wish. And it's also her lifetime wish too. We also have to collect 40,000 simoleons in resort profit in total, which is a lot. I mean, the reviews are going up. So I feel like soon it's going to become 5-star naturally over time. I just think it's the kind of thing that like, you know, will take a little bit of time. What's Casa Flangelica on? This ugly monstrosity. See, even this one has gone up to 2 stars now. I think it just takes like a little bit of time. Although I like that the reviews tell you what to do. So you have like a general direction how to improve it. The pool bar was so crowded, I couldn't find a place to sit and enjoy. Bollocks. Absolute bollocks. This resort is completely dead, mate. I don't know what you're talking about. Oh, there's trash here. Right, come on, Flangelica Foofy, clean it up. Time to get to work, please, madam. Clean up all your trash. Where's she running to? Oh, she's picking up more. That's very responsible of you. Oh my God, she can walk through. I didn't even realize. That is so cool. You can make like a walkway with this. You could do like go really hard on the building with the resorts. This is actually really cool. They're also saying the hot tub's ridiculously crowded. Although it's saying that there are plenty of food choices for my kids to pick from. So it's a good idea to have all the extra food stands. I cleaned out most of my savings to pay for this vacation. Well, what a disappointment. I am sorry, Casa Flangelica did not meet your expectations. Another review said that they should add chlorine in the pool. Oh, there we go. We can chlorinate it. That's good. Didn't know you could do that. But I like, you can literally like customize everything. Though nobody's eating at the food stand and the drink stand over here. I'm just thinking maybe if we put a table outside because we don't actually have one, maybe people will start eating out there. Maybe we could do a bench too. Oh my God, I forgot about a bar. Let's chuck a bar there. Although, oh, see, the only annoying cash grabbery thing about bars in The Sims 3 is if you want to hire a mixologist, you need to have the late night pack installed. I do have that pack, but I don't have it installed because with The Sims 3, it runs a lot smoother if you only have one pack installed at a time, as a tip for you if you do play that game. And oh my God, I completely forgot I placed a little cow plant down here, although I think it's broken because it's scorched. I actually miss The Sims 2, where with lifetime rewards, you could actually get a cow plant from there. In The Sims 3 and 4, you can't really get like physical objects as rewards, which is a bit annoying. Anyway, I guess the hotel is looking like a little bit bigger. I swear this lady's been here on her laptop for ages. She's an employee. Why isn't she working? Bloody idiots. Obviously, it's going to take time to make it a 5-star resort. That was honestly well fun. Like if I had the time, I would definitely actually like make like a proper one, starting off really small as like a little villa style resort, like a boutique hotel, and then build it up. But for now, I'm going to leave it and just see if the reviews go up bit by bit. Obviously, we've got Complejo Flangelica as well. So Moist Miriam, who's been patiently standing in this bathroom for the entire Let's Play. In the next episode, we're going to make her a lifeguard because it's a brand new career that comes with this pack. Also, I might try and turn her into the most gorgeous mermaid you've ever seen, because as you can see, she's really gorgeous. Oh my God, she's doing something so seductively. Just as I said that, she's like, ooh. And by that point, hopefully the resort should be better. And of course, Fanny Mae, we have not forgotten about you. We still have some uncharted islands to explore. I will pop the link to every single episode in the description of the video once it becomes available. If you're impatient and you want to see another Sims 3 Let's Play, I suggest one of these two here. Otherwise, thank you for watching. See you in the next one.